Congrats, my friends. You've just hit the big time. What are you going to do now that you're rich and famous? Go to Disney, of course. But remember, things look very different in Disney World when money is no object. Hey everybody, it's AJ for Disney Food Blog, and we're gonna live it up today with this video. So how would you navigate Disney if you were a member of the financially elite? Skip the massive lines, stay in the swankiest resort rooms, dine in the fanciest signature restaurants. Some of the things I'm gonna talk about today are a little too extravagant, I totally get that. However, some of these experiences might actually be doable when we finally sell that brilliant invention we've been working on. And we're also gonna give you a few suggestions of how to feel like a VIP right now in Disney World, even if you maybe aren't pulling in Bill Gates level money. Let's get started. First up on our list is take a VIP tour. Let's take the advice of Aerosmith over at Rock and Roller Coaster and snag some backstage passes. Disney World offers several VIP and backstage tours. These provide exclusive behind the scenes glimpses into how the Disney magic is created at the parks on the daily. But if you've got the cash to burn, then you want to book the VIP tour that gives you the chance to skip all the lines all day long. This is the Walt Disney World private VIP tour where guests can create their dream Disney Day itineraries that'll be made into reality. Thanks to your private tour guide, you'll be able to jump from park to park if you want to, using private backstage transportation. That's right, no waiting half an hour for a Disney bus with this tour. And you can ride anything you want as many times as you want with little to no wait, as long as you do it while the tour guide is on the clock. These VIP tours, which you can also get in Disneyland, range in price from $425 to $750 per hour, depending on when you're visiting. And the catch, you gotta book that tour guide for a minimum of 7 hours. So you're gonna be paying an extra $3,000 to $5,000 for the day, plus optional gratuity, but that price will cover up to 10 people in your travel party. It will not cover park admission, though. You're still going to have to pay for that valid theme park ticket on top of the VIP tour price tag. Now, a tour like this can be beneficial during super busy holiday seasons or for big groups who can all pitch in with the cost. This tour will let you do nearly every ride you want to accomplish on the same day without worrying about the massive queue lines. So hey, the price may sound really scary initially, but it might not be beyond reason depending on your budget and how many people you've got willing to throw some money in the pot. Now, if you want the uber VIP creme de la creme tour and you've got even more cash to burn, try on the World of Dreams tour for size. This tour is fully customizable. Whatever rides, restaurants, photo sessions, and experiences you want are fair game. That includes a tour of the exclusive Cinderella Castle suite, a place you only get to see if you've got the money, the clout, or you've won a very rare sweepstakes. Your food is included, private transportation between the parks, basically anything you want within reason can happen during your 12-hour ultra VIP tour for up to 6 guests. The only thing not included is your park ticket and park hopper option if you want to visit more than one park each day. So how much will it cost to have Disney World at the tips of your fingers? $12,000. Yep, want to extend your VIP experience to more days? Add $10,000 for each subsequent day. Now, if you still want to feel like you're of VIP status without spending thousands, you can always try one of the less expensive and still cool but won't get you skip the line access, other Disney World backstage tours when they become available again. Want to know a couple of my favorites? Well, the Wild Africa Trek is a great one for all you Animal Kingdom fans out there because it lets you travel through the Kilimanjaro exhibits and also take a peek at the animal care that happens throughout the day. It's a 3-hour tour, costs $139 to $249 per person on top of your single day ticket. The Behind the Scenes tour over at Epcot is probably the most affordable of the backstage tours. This hour-long escapade takes place inside Living with the Land and gives you an up-close and personal look at each of the greenhouses within the ride while also getting you the inside scoop about the wonderful world of agriculture. Which, that sounds like a joke, but it is pretty cool when you look at what Epcot's doing with hydroponic growing and other cool stuff like that. When available, this experience costs $29 per person on top of your regular ticket price. But my favorite tour has got to be the Backstage Magic Tour, which I did with my dad years and years and years ago. It's a 7-hour behind-the-scenes guided walkthrough tour that shows you Disney's deepest and darkest, okay, not darkest, I got carried away there, secrets that go into maintaining the magic of the parks. A few of the things you'll learn along the way are the park's audio animatronics, the colorful character costuming, and the ride repair shops. You'll even get to walk through through those underground Magic Kingdom utilidors sometimes. Now that's VIP status. This tour costs only $275 per person. I know I say only, it is a high price, but it's 7 hours and it's very cool. And this price also covers lunch over at Whispering Canyon Cafe and Wilderness Lodge. Sometimes that lunch place changes, so don't get your heart set, but it'll be something mid-priced like that. All right, speaking of eating, let's talk about dining like royalty. We're DFB, so of course we're gonna talk about food. Let's start out strong here. After all, we are celebs in this little fantasy of ours. How about a meal over at Victoria and Albert's in Disney's Grand Floridian Resort? This Victorian-style dinner is a three-hour venture that allows you to choose either a 7-course or 10-course pre-fixed dining experience. The 7-course tasting menu costs $250 per guest, unless you're in the mood to splurge on some wine pairings, which would make the experience an extra $150 per guest. But what if you're feeling really high class and you want some fancy fish eggs to go along with your meal? The International Caviar Tasting Enhancement will cost a whopping $295. Oh, did I say you could choose a 7-course and 10-course meal? Let me tell you a little bit about the chef's table, which is the 11-course experience that gives you front row seats to the kitchen as they prepare your meal. This experience also provides you with a selection of foods based around your specific preferences. Only one party gets to dine at the chef's table each evening, so that makes it especially VIP, and that type of exclusivity is going to cost you $350 per guest. I've done the Victoria and Albert's chef's table a couple of times, and it is by far my favorite dining experience in Disney World. Even though I'm not really a fancy restaurant kind of person, it's a lot of fun back there because you can ask any questions you want to ask. You can watch those incredible sous chefs learning as they go and having so much fun, and it's just a lot of fun to be back there if you really make the most of it. But wait, there is more. This place even has a special water menu with imported waters ranging from $7 to $120 in price. Yeah, you know you're living large when you're drinking $120 water. By the way, it's from a specific glacier and they only harvest it like once a millennia. Yes, I'm exaggerating. So I'm sure it's delicious water, but I did not try it. Though I did hear Kurt Russell got it once. Now let's keep moving right along to a super special club you might have or might not have heard of before, Club 33. Club 33 is a hush-hush club for those who've got the funds to join the membership, and these club members receive access to specialty Disney experiences, including access to Club 33 dining locations. The original Club 33 Hideaway is located in Disneyland's New Orleans Square and was originally built to be a place where Walt Disney himself could entertain special guests and family members. Walt Disney passed before he could use the space, but his legacy continues through this exclusive membership program. Additional Club 33 locations now exist in Walt Disney World, Tokyo Disneyland, and Shanghai Disneyland, but you have to become a member of each resort separately. Now, while I'm on a roll here in the food space, let's talk about 21 Royal too. 21 Royal is located right above Disneyland's Pirates of the Caribbean. I know most of this video is about Disney World, but Disneyland is where the celebrities live, right? Much like Club 33, this location was originally intended to be a private apartment for Walt Disney, which would have been an upgrade from his studio apartment above the fire station, but he was never able to use it for that intended purpose. Today, the space is a high-end exclusive dining experience that you don't have to have a club membership to enjoy. All you and your 12 closest friends need is a 5-hour time frame, plenty of stomach space for the whole 7-course meal, and about $15,000. But this $15,000 doesn't just cover your meal. You'll also receive valet parking up the Grand Californian, park hopper tickets, wine and cocktail pairings, an awesome view of Fantasmic, and oh yeah, 3 super awesome butlers for the evening. Now, I have a whole video about my experience at 21 Royal, and I gotta say, this once-in-a-lifetime experience is an absolute blast and delicious, but it should be for that price, right? My notes to you are just to remember that you can't get in the beds, so don't do that. Also, don't run water in the bathtub, okay? All right, let's bring it down a notch, and by bringing it down a notch, I'm still talking about uber-expensive dining splurges that are maybe more obtainable, but still super high-end and fancy with a capital F. If you're rolling in the dough, you might want to try out some of those top-shelf alcoholic beverages Disney's got in their fine dining inventories. Over at La Cava del Tequila in Epcot, you can try the Supreme Tequila Flight for $195. I'm gonna let you in on a little secret. You can still enjoy the drinks here without paying hundreds. Okay, maybe that's not a secret, but I felt like it needed to be said. The specialty cocktails range in price from $15 to $22 and are super unique and strong. And there's even one developed by an actual celebrity, Neil Patrick Harris, called the Black Magic Margarita, which is a frozen concoction made with mezcal, blackberry puree, cassis liqueur, lime, and mint. All right, make your way over to the Hollywood Brown Derby at Disney's Hollywood Studios. with a bunch of celebs on the wall, of course, and you can try that cognac flight featuring Hennessy VSOP, XO, and Paradis for $90. Not all the after-dinner drink flights at this table service restaurant are in the $90 range, though. The lowest priced after-dinner drink flight you can purchase to still feel like you're a celebrity status is the Sparkling Flight. Sparkling, like your name and lights, get it? This champagne flight goes for $21. Need some more dessert wine options in your life? California Grill over at Disney's Contemporary Resort has you covered. The dessert wines, port, sherry, and Madeira options come in 3-ounce pours and range in price from $11 to $1,000. Nope, that's not a typo. There's literally a Taylor Fladgate option here that's $1,000 for 3 ounces. So, you know, bottoms up, I guess. California Grill is one of those signature dining restaurants that's as high-priced as you want to make it. You don't have to break the bank here. You can still play the part of the glitz and glamour while ordering options like one of the $23 artisanal pizzas as your meal. Or maybe you want to nosh on one of the hand-rolled sushi rolls instead, which range in price from $23 to $29. Totally your call. You can order something more affordable and still experience the exclusive Magic Kingdom fireworks viewing from the restaurant's observation deck, and that's a win-win. Now, I know Disney's Grand Floridian gave us sticker shock just a second ago at Victoria and Albert's, but let's go back to the Deluxe Resort for a second, slip into the Enchanted Rose Lounge to see what's on their menu. This Beauty and the Beast themed location has a selection of adult drinks that make it easy for you to rack up the bill, especially if you want one of those wines from the wine library that can range from $110 to $780. If you're looking to purchase a bottle for the table, you gotta impress your friends, right? That's how much it's gonna run ya. You can also order wine by the glass though, which is a lot easier to swallow price-wise. The Enchanted Rose has a selection of non-alcoholic beverages too, for those who want to socialize without partaking in alcohol or the major cash spending. Non-alcoholic options include spritzers, teas, coolers, and coffees that range from $4 to $14. Okay, now I've got to do a quick shout out to one of my favorites, because this restaurant always makes me feel like royalty without the price tag. You may already know what I'm going to say by now, but you guys, Wine Bar George is amazing. Not only do they have delicious appetizers like the crispy mac and cheese bites and the steak frites, but the servers here know their stuff, and they're going to be able to hook you up with the wine that's right for you and your preferences and your wallet. Talk about the royal treatment. You'll find the pedestrian $8 to $15 glass of wine here and the expected but kind of pricey bottles hitting the $140 range, but you'll also find the wildly expensive in the restaurant's outstanding by the ounce section of the menu. These are high-end wines that are offered in 1, 3, and 6-ounce pours. At the low end, the Tempranillo for $4 for 1 ounce, on the high end, an 88 French Cabernet starting at $84 for 1 ounce, and going up to $500 for a 6-ounce pour. Next up, we're going to talk about staying in the swankiest rooms. Being famous is exhausting. Time to find a place to crash for the night, right? If you're living large in Disney World, you're probably going to want to check out one of these room options. First up, we got the Presidential Suites, which you can find at numerous Disney resorts. These suites can be the size of a person's house. We're talking multiple thousands of square feet. They are spacious comes. The Presidential Suite at Disney's Contemporary Resort is located on the 14th floor, just below California Grill, and has 5 balconies that each have a fantastic view of Magic Kingdom, meaning prime fireworks viewing every single night. These Presidential Suites range from $1,900 to $2,800 per night. Now, the Royal Asante Presidential Suite over at the Jumbo House in Disney's Animal Kingdom Lodge features authentic African art, natural wood and stone furniture, and spectacular savanna views. The price to stay here starts at around $2,400 per night, and it looks so cool. Disney's Beach Club Resort, Disney's Polynesian Village Resort, Disney Boardwalk Inn Resort, and Coronado Springs Resort also have Presidential Suites. And if you choose one over at the Grand Floridian, then you might just get to stay in the same suite Princess Diana and her boys stayed in years ago. Literal royalty, everyone. The cheapest of these suites is over at Coronado Springs, which makes sense since it's the only moderate resort in the list, and the pricing for that room starts at $1,250 per night, which is just pennies, really. But for rule of thumb purposes, the average price for a presidential or vice presidential suite in Disney World is about $2,000 a night, so it's time to sell that novel you've been working on. Now, how can it get any more expensive than that? Why don't you ask Four Seasons Resort in Orlando? Usually I'm going to tell you that third-party hotels will save you money, but not in the case of Four Seasons. Four Seasons is AAA 5-diamond with luxurious spas, peaceful golf ranges, dazzling pools, even fireworks and Disney character dining. This is a swanky resort, y'all, but it comes at a hefty price. If 2 adults and 2 kids were to stay for a week at one of the Four Seasons rooms during the first week of October, they should expect to pay between $1,260 and $7,981 per night, and that's not even covering their presidential and royal suite options, which can end up costing you at a starting price of $13,000 per night. But hey, it's a popular place for celebrities to stay, so how about that view of Epcot? But if you're truly living that celeb status, maybe you'll get the chance to stay at the Cinderella Castle suite located in the iconic Cinderella Castle itself. You'll have to be invited or win a contest to ever stay in the Cinderella Castle suite, but if we're famous in this hypothetical situation, then we're for sure gonna be invited, right? Totes and goats. Similar to 21 Royal, the Cinderella Castle suite's original purpose was to be a space Walt Disney and his family could stay in while visiting Walt Disney World. But since Walt passed before the completion of Disney World, the apartment was never really finished. In 2006, for the Year of a Million Dreams celebration, the Cinderella Castle suite was born. 2006 provided guests the chance to win a stay in this luxurious room, suite, apartment. Since then, this has become Disney World's most exclusive digs. If you're fortunate enough to be invited here, you and up to six people will have a 24-hour concierge, a magic mirror TV, an antique limestone fireplace, stained glass windows, and a jacuzzi tub complete with a starry sky overhead. But let's break the illusion here for a bit. What if you're not a celebrity and you're not swimming in dollar bills like Uncle Scrooge? Can you still live it up on the Disney World property? Well, the fact of the matter is that even the more affordable places to stay on Disney property are still going to be pretty pricey from most of our perspective. However, some options are more reasonable. Want to stay at a Disney Vacation Club hotel without paying for the DVC membership? Well, you can rent DVC points through a DVC rental service like David's DVC Rental. We've got an entire video on how to do this and save hundreds in the process. Those are usually larger rooms that sleep more people, and they're all in deluxe resorts. There are also more affordable family suites that'll still sleep up to six guests at Disney's Art of Animation and Disney's All-Star Music Resort. Disney's All-Star Music Suites range from $289 to $512 per night, while Disney's Art of Animation Suites range from $449 to $771 per night. Still crazy expensive, but compared to $13,000, I'll take it. The cabins at Fort Wilderness also offer more space and sleep up to six guests without the VIP price tag. These standalone cabins have full kitchens, a bedroom with queen bed and a bunk bed set, and a living room with a sleep sofa. Prices range from around $400 to $700 per night, though you can often find discounts that bring that down to around $350 per night depending on when you're visiting. And if you don't need the presidential suite, you can find very luxurious standard rooms at the Grand Floridian or Contemporary. You'll still get that VIP feel at a lower cost than the multi-room suites. It's still a stinking high cost, $700 to over $1,000 without a discount, but that's a lower cost than the presidential suites at least. But don't be afraid to consider staying outside Disney World property too. The Waldorf Astoria Deluxe Suite costs as much as a standard room at the Grand Floridian, and the suites will provide you with four-person dining room, walkout balcony, and separate living room. Come on. My personal favorite third-party hotels to stay at are over at Disney Swan and Dolphin. The rooms here are deluxe quality at a moderate resort price and still provide you with all the special perks that Disney World Resort guests receive, like complimentary transportation and extended park hours. Staying in a mega suite here, think two bedrooms and full dining room, will cost you just a shade more than a standard room at Grand Floridian, and you get to walk to two parks from here. So it's worth thinking about if you need more space for more people. Next on our list of how to do Disney if you're rich, rent away, baby. Ready to rent out the Disney parks Michael Jackson style? Well, the Disney Meetings and Events website allows those who are wanting to plan corporate, association, or social events to rent out sections of Disney World. And in some cases, you can even rent out an entire park for your after-hours event. The price to rent out an entire park depends on your location, which could be at Disney World, Disneyland Aulani, Hong Kong Disneyland, Shanghai Disneyland, or Disneyland Paris, as well as the time of year you decide to book the event and the number of guests that'll be in attendance. To rent a park like Magic Kingdom for 3 hours with limited experiences available, you're looking at a rough starting cost of around $180,000. Is renting out the entire park a little too extravagant for your pocketbook? Perhaps just a portion of one of the parks will suffice. In Disney World, you can rent out various sections of Epcot, Animal Kingdom, Hollywood Studios, and other locations you can rent include the Atlantic Dance Hall on Disney's Boardwalk or Fantasia Gardens Pavilion, which can hold up to 875 guests. Ready to get the ball rolling? Then you'll need to submit an online request on the Disney Meetings and Events website, stating your venue preference, your event date, your number of attendees, your budget range, your contact info, and any other special requests you'd like for your event. You can also call the planning numbers listed at the bottom of the website or speak to a cast member directly. After that, gotta wait and see if your request is approved. Now, we used to rent out sections of Epcot for fireworks viewing, for meet and greets for our readers and followers. And it was super fun because we created a custom menu that included all of our favorite snacks from everywhere in Disney World. So we would have carrot cake cookies, school bread, red velvet cupcakes, which are gone. They don't have those anymore over there in Hollywood Studios, but we had this awesome array of our favorite eats. And then we had all these cool people around us who had come to watch the fireworks with us, and it was super fun. It was expensive, but it wasn't crazy expensive when you have a lot of people chipping in. So it is doable, and it is something that anyone can do if the budget is high enough for your special occasion. Now, we of course had people purchase tickets to come to those events with us, so we didn't have to foot the entire bill, but it was still pretty pricey. Now, you can also rent out Disney park areas for your wedding day, just like Disney's Fairy Tale Weddings show. True celebrity status at its finest. You can rent a wedding venue in Disney World, Disneyland, Aulani, or on one of the Disney cruise ships. There are a lot of prices on the Disney Weddings website that you're going to have to sift through while you're planning your happily ever after event. You got to decide on the food and beverages, the floral arrangements, the decor, the photography, the entertainment, the transportation. Oh, it's stressing me out right now. That last one's probably the most important because you can book Cinderella's coach to drop you off at the ceremony, and that sounds like an absolute dream, minus the glass slippers. Ceremony venues are going to range in price though. If you want to get married at Luau Point, Disney's Polynesian Village Resort, expect to pay $2,500 for that venue. You want to get married at the China Pavilion in Epcot's World Showcase or outside Tower of Terror at Disney's Hollywood Studios, then you're looking at $4,500 venues. But of course, the biggest price point's got to be Cinderella Castle with an after-hours venue price of $30,000. Disney does have a wedding-specific area over at Disney's Grand Floridian Resort and Spa, appropriately titled the Disney Wedding Pavilion. This is decorated with white and gold features. It's a little venue with a crystal-clear view of Cinderella Castle, and the venue can hold up to 250 guests and costs $5,000. Realistically, few of us will ever be able to rent out the park, let alone get married there, but that doesn't mean you'll never be able to rent out a space in Disney, period. You could rent out a space for a special meal, like the water room at Takumi Te, the Japan Pavilion of Epcot's World Showcase. Now, this is us talking about restaurants again, but this might be a solid option for those who want to rent out an area of the park for your business or private event without having to pay for an entire house in the process. This is still a pricey endeavor, mind you. It definitely has a similar vibe to Victoria and Albert's when it comes to experience. If you rent the water room at this fine dining Japanese restaurant, expect to be there for 3 hours as you experience an exclusive 9-course menu at the chef's table. The water room is secluded from the rest of the restaurant in a section with tranquil waterfall and a long table that can sit up to 8 people. It's absolutely beautiful in there. The price to reserve this experience is $180 per person, which with the prices we've been talking about today is relatively small. And for 8 people max, you're looking to spend around $1,440. Expensive? Oh yeah, but compared to the other rental options around Disney World, this private experience is potentially more obtainable. Whichever way you look at it, renting out a chunk of Disney World is going to cost a good chunk of change though. All right, let's talk about luxurious shopping sprees. Is all that money still burning a hole in your pocket? Then it's time to shop. Gucci and Disney have collabed to create some high-end merchandise for the dedicated Disney celeb fan. In the past, we've seen Gucci come out with $290 Mickey mugs, $1,600 Lunar New Year watches, and $1,800 Donald Duck nylon jackets. Pandora Jewelry also collaborated with Disney and even has a storefront in Disney Springs. You can customize your Pandora charm bracelet and necklace with your favorite Disney characters and icons. The prices here range from $55 to $65 per charm, unless you're wanting a specialty charm like the rose gold Fantasyland Castle Charm, currently listed on Shop Disney for $115. But if you're really famous, you might just be invited to do a merchandise collaboration with Disney yourself. The Disney Parks website states that the limited edition Disney Parks Ear Headband Collection is designed by some of our favorite celebrities, designers, and artists, quote unquote. Some of these ears cost upwards of $600, but now that they're sold out, who knows how much the dark web's charging for those bad boys. Or maybe you want to throw all caution to the wind and just splurge on that $37,000 Swarovski Crystal Disney Castle over at Erebus Brothers in the Magic Kingdom, because why not? Now, there are a lot of ways to experience Disney, but if you want to live it up celebrity style, well, here you go. And honestly, I'm sure there are a lot of celeb perks that we don't even know about. So once you've made it big, come back and tell us about them. However, just because you can afford something doesn't mean it's the best choice for you to actually buy. We know that despite what's in your bank accounts, DFB viewers are all extremely careful financially, and you stick with us to make sure you use your money as wisely as possible when you do Disney. So don't forget to sign up for our DFB newsletter. The link is down in the description description below, and it's a treasure trove of deals, discounts, and savings that will ensure you have the best trip you can, even a VIP trip, in a way that's affordable for you. Thanks for listening, everybody. Thanks for watching. As always, this is AJ for Disney Food Blog, and we'll see you real soon.